all girls are different. But sometime between the ages of 9 and 16, one very special event happens to every girl.
I don't know yet. I haven't grown up all the way.
Well, you start developing and you start changing physically.
You start your period.
Boy.
All of that does happen. And between 9 and 16, certain specific changes take place in your body. For one thing, a soft growth of hair appears under the arms and in the pubic area. This is true for boys as well as girls. And this is the time when a girl's figure begins to develop. Hips fill out. Breasts begin to become rounder and fuller. And it is now that girls start to menstruate.
Menstruation?
Explain it. Don't you know?
A female cycle, it happens about every 28 days.
It happens to every girl.
You have every month.
It means you can have babies.
Oh, you... I know what it is.
Something that all girls go through. You have it once a month. It's a natural process. And it enables you to have children.
She took my line away.
All girls are born with a special place in their bodies where babies can grow, called the uterus. It's in the lower abdomen below the stomach. As a girl matures, a special lining of blood and tissue periodically forms in the uterus to make a soft, nutritious place for a baby to grow. If a baby is not conceived, the velvety lining isn't needed, and so it is released and flows out of the body through the vagina, from the uterus to the outside of the body. That's menstruation. Menstruation is a very important part of human life. Every girl has two ovaries containing thousands of microscopic egg cells. About once a month, one of these cells matures and is released from one of the ovaries. It enters the fallopian tube and travels slowly to the uterus. We've greatly enlarged the size of the egg cell here so that you can see it. If a cell reaches the uterus without having been fertilized by a male sperm cell, the egg and the special lining built up in the uterus disintegrate and flow through the vaginal canal out of the body. The actual flow is rather small, and it lasts only about 3 to 8 days. This time is often called the period. Then the process begins all over again and repeats itself about once a month.
I've been menstruating since I was 12. 11, I think. Not quite 11. About a year ago, 16.
I think it was the summer of 6th grade going into the 7th.
10, I think it was 10, 6th grade. About the same age, but about half a year later.
These girls are all 12, but very different in physique, in coordination, and personality. Begin menstruating anytime from 9 to 16. The average age is between 12 and 13. Whenever it happens for you is the right time. Although the average menstrual They are designed to absorb the flow, and there's a special moisture-proof shield inside so nothing can leak through and show. A sanitary belt will keep the napkin in place. The short tab of the napkin is attached to the front fastener, and the long tab of the napkin is attached to the back fastener. The belt is worn around the waist and holds the napkin safely and comfortably between the legs. If you prefer, you can wear a special panty with elastic loops to hold the napkin in place. Or there's a new kind of napkin that doesn't need belts, pins, or special panties, so it's very comfortable and convenient. This kind has special adhesive strips on the back, so you can attach the napkin quickly and securely right to your own panties.
How often should you change feminine napkins? Once a day? Every 2 or 3 hours? Whenever you want?
It's a good idea to change every 2 to 3 hours, since the menstrual flow does have an odor after it leaves the body. Frequent changes will help you to keep feeling fresh and comfortable all day, every day. Some days the flow will be lighter than other days. In the very beginning of your period, for example, and on the last 2 or 3 days, the flow may be lighter. That's what these little mini pads are for, the times when you don't need all the absorbency of a full-size napkin. And mini pads are perfect for those times when you're not quite sure when your period's going to start. They let you be prepared anyway.
How do you dispose of feminine napkins? Flush down the toilet? Wrap and put in wastebasket?
With some, you just wrap them in toilet paper and put them in the wastebasket. But there are also new kinds that are made to be flushed. Just check the package first to be sure they are made of biodegradable materials that will disintegrate and be returned to nature. Since there are many different kinds of feminine napkins, you might want to start with a beginner's kit to help you decide what's best for you. This booklet will tell you how to get one and will help you understand more about what happens during menstruation. Your teacher, school nurse, or leader of your girls' organization can tell you how to get a copy of Growing Up and Liking It.
During my period, my hair gets a little oily.
Once in a while, I get a pimple, but that's all.
Should you bathe or wash your hair during your period?
Some people used to think you shouldn't, but now we know that it's especially important to take a bath or shower every day during your period. You tend to perspire more, and if your hair gets oily, well, you'll naturally want to wash it. Then, get plenty of sleep every night, and eat a balanced diet. That way you'll feel and look good during your period, and all the rest of the month, too.
Does every girl get cramps during her period?
Well, sometimes I get cramps and sometimes I don't.
Like, some girls like to get cramps and, you know, like, have a headache or stomachache or something. But I don't get anything.
I never get them.
I never do now, but I used to.
Many girls do experience some cramps or a slight feeling of pressure in the lower abdomen during menstruation. These are exercises that will help relieve or stop cramps. You can do them all month long. They're good for your figure. There's no reason why you can't do all the things you normally do while you're menstruating. But what about swimming during your period? You can go swimming during menstruation if you wear a tampon.
Tampon?
A tampon is another comfortable, hygienic way to absorb the menstrual flow. Some come with applicators and some do not. A tampon is inserted into the vagina and the muscles hold it in place so it can't slip. The instructions on the package show how to insert it. They're small, but tampons are very absorbent. And since they are worn internally, there's no worry about
Wow.
Being a woman, and I was always looking forward to it.
It's just natural.
Growing up isn't always fun, but it does have a lot to recommend it. I used to dream of being an actress, but being... being a woman is one of the things I like best about myself. I think you'll like it, too.
It's better than being a boy.